Now we crack through walls, come through floors, bust through ceilings, knock down doors. Now when we're on the tape, we're fresh out the box. You can hear our sound, four blocks and blocks, for every living person. We're a rumble tree, it's me and DMC. Jay, where's the beat?
And the truth of how I became DMC was like this. I was sitting there one day and I was like, okay, Thor is the son of Odin from Asgard. He has a brother named Loki, and he has a hammer. That's in that world. In this world here, I'm Darryl. My father's name is Byford. I got a brother named Alfred, and I got a mic. So because of comic books and imagination is just image in. When you imagine it, it comes to fruition. So I sat there one day, I said, Thor is the son of Odin. You know who I'm going to be for the rest of my life? Son of Byford, brother of Al. Banners my mother and runs my pal. It's McDaniels, not McDonald's. These rhymes are Darryl's, those burgers are Ronald's. I ran down my family tree. My mother, my father, my brother, and me. I spoke it into existence and it came to pass.
The comic book is an alternate reality, an alternate universe. It's me, Darryl McDaniels. Everything that's true about me in this universe, except in the alternate universe, I never become a rapper. I never meet Run. I actually graduate from St. John's University, and I become a teacher. And that all came about when we first put the comic together. They was like, yo, D, let me ask you something. What would you be doing if you never went into the music business? And I was like, I don't know. All I know, my whole life was a Catholic school kid, straight A student, always on the honor roll, and all I did was read, collect, and draw comic books. So when they asked me that, the only thing that I really knew was education, so I probably became a teacher. So in the alternate universe, I'm a teacher, but hip hop is being done by the students. Rock and roll is being done by the students. Heavy metal is being done by the students. So I'm a teacher in the 80s-like universe where all genres of music, style, fashion, history, social issues, personal issues. The universe is not just superheroes, it's supernatural, it's spiritual, it's occult, it's technology, but it looks like it's taking place in the 80s like universe. Feels like the 80s, sounds like the 80s. There's break dancing, there's graffiti on the wall, there's subway trains with the graffiti on it. But the question is, it looks like the 80s, it feels like the 80s, but it could be the future. We put it in the 80s like scenario, not just because I'm DMC and I come from the hip hop era of the 80s, but people forget that the 80s was one of the most innovative, creative, musical, fashionable, artistic time periods in history. When you came to New York, if you came to New York in the 80s, there was Run DMC, there was Blondie, there was the Ramones, there was Madonna. On the art side, there was Keith Haring and Basquiat. You know, musically, it was Lou Reed. So we had the punk scene and the hip-hop scene exploding because disco had just died. So in that universe, I'm not DMC the king of rock. I'm DMC a teacher who happens to discover that I have superhuman powers.
I heard that actually comics kind of gave you the courage to get into music, so if you could tell me a little bit about that.
Yeah, if it wasn't for comic books, I would never had the courage to get up on stage and rhyme in front of you. When hip-hop came over the bridge, and I first noticed it in like 73, for me, it wasn't like, oh wow, I could be in showbiz and I could get money, I could be famous. I was a little kid. All I did as a kid was read, collect, and draw comic books. Read, collect, and draw comic books. So all that education, all of that information, all that creativity, and all that imagination that I was getting from the comic books was all holed up inside me. I had no way to release it. And then when hip hop came along, I was like, oh shoot. You could tell stories about who you are over comic books. So to give me the courage and confidence to get on a mic, what I did was Darryl McDaniels, the initials of my name is DMC, D from Darryl, MC from McDaniels. But when I stepped to the microphone, my old mannered Catholic school kid Darryl McDaniels no longer is Darryl McDaniels. I transform into the mighty king of rock. I transform into the devastating mic controller. And I was able to take the D and then the M and the C of my initials and do what Marvel comic books taught me. Marvel comic books taught me in life. And prior to hip hop, I was doing this every day when I walked out my door into the harsh jungle of being a little kid trying to survive peer pressure and drugs and death and despair and destruction. Marvel comic books taught me to find yourself in an adjective and then tell the world who you are. For instance, the Amazing Spider-Man, the Incredible Hulk. So DMC, the Mighty King of Rock, DMC is not Darryl McDaniels anymore. He transforms into the devastating Mind Controller.
Roll to the rock, rock to the roll. DMC stands for devastating Mind Control. You can't touch me with a 10-foot pole. And I even made the devil sell me his soul.
So when I was stepping up on stage, even when Run first met me, yeah, I had good rhymes. When Run thought I was just, I had some dope rhymes. He didn't know I was make-believing that I was something. And those words are powerful, that make-believe, pretend, you know, imaginative universe, no, that imaginative world really manifests itself when you start making believe you're something. So for me, I'm pretending to be the superpowered, most powerful entity in the hip-hop world, calling myself the King of Rock. Now when I walk the earth, yo, King! Yo, the King is here, King DMC. And I say to myself, man, I was just playing, but was I?
The beautiful thing about this whole comic book creative thing is, I remember when I was a little kid and I used to get teased, man, you into that corny pretend make-believe stuff. And I used to go, you goddamn right I'm into the corny Think about those words, make-believe, make the people believe. And once you start believing, it becomes a reality.
Is it true that you sold some of your comics to buy your first set of turntables?
Yes. To actually get into hip-hop, when I noticed that all the DJs and the MCs was playing at the block parties. And prior to then, I was still riding my bike, playing with my skateboard, reading my comic books. So I saw the block parties, and I saw the house parties, and I saw the park parties and stuff like that. But I didn't think I was that. But when I started writing my rhymes, which was for me, it was just for me. But then I realized, oh man, you gotta get out there and do it. So the problem me and my brother had was, if you didn't have no money, you didn't get no turntables and records. And the only people in the neighborhood that had turntables and record money was the people selling weed. So me and my brother, we wasn't no weed sellers and stuff like that, but we had a huge, massive comic book collection. So we kind of became entrepreneurs at a very young age. We was like, how do we get some turntables? We had every issue of Marvel. So we took our pens and pencils and made homemade flyers. The McDaniels brothers is doing a comic book sale. And we took thumbtacks and tacked them up to all the telephone poles. So we had to do a comic book sale so we could get enough money. We needed $40 for the mixer, and we needed like $56 for the turntable. So we did a comic book sale to get two turntables and a mixer and some records. And that was my actual physical, you know, coming downstairs and seeing turntables in the basement. But still in all, that was just for me. I mean, my brother was a little older, so Anthony, shout out to Anthony and Booby, the older kids really wanted to be like Flash and them. But for me, it was just me pretending to be that. I had no idea it would manifest itself into something real. Yo, yo, what up? This is me, DMC, in the place to be on Mystery Girl Radio. I want you to do something for me. Find Mystery Girl.